Hi folks, today I will show you how to make tzatziki, that famous Greek sauce that people put on souvlaki, eggplants, beef, lamb, you name it. It's really good, it's very easy to make. So here we go.
Alright, let's get all our ingredients together, and here is everything you're gonna need. You need 2 cups of good Greek yogurt, strained. You need 1 cucumber that's gonna be shredded. You need also 3 cloves of garlic, that's going to be shredded thin, a small bunch of dillweed, olive oil, and salt. From kitchen tools, you're going to need your good knife, a shredder, a strainer, and if you have a potato peeler handy, that helps too. So first I'm going to peel my cucumber. That's where the potato peeler comes handy. Try to clean up as you go. You don't want to end up with a mess in the kitchen for a handful of food. Okay, now I'm going to chop this dill, but I'm going to cut off the stems. I really don't need too much crunch, it's a sauce after all. So I have to chop it rather thin, like you see. Alright, as you see it, I cut it rather thin, you know, small pieces. And now I'm gonna put it in the yogurt. And I will shred the cucumber that goes in there too. I will shred the cucumber on the thicker side of the shredder because you need to have some texture in there. And if you do it on the thin side, then the whole cucumber is going to be just water. There will be nothing left of that. Even as it is, it's pretty watery, so I'm gonna use the strainer and I'm gonna put the cucumber in there and squeeze it a little bit to get out some of the water, because I don't want my tzatziki sauce to end up too watery, too thin. Okay, it has to be like cream. There you go. So, see how much water comes out of it? Yeah, and I just squeeze it lightly, I don't really overdo it. So we put the squeezed cucumber together with the yogurt, and we have to shred the garlic too. Now I use 3 cloves of garlic, which is okay for my taste. You can use more or less if you like, but you know, if your mouth burns and if your neighbors and their pets start dropping dead, that's too much, you know. It just, don't overdo it, really. It's always a good idea to start small, and you can add garlic or you can add salt after you finish and you try it and you think it needs more. But yeah, don't overdo it from the beginning, because you can't take it out. You can put some more in, but you can't take out what you put in. So we're gonna mix it now. After I put my salt, about a half teaspoon maybe, I can always put some more later, and olive oil. I'm gonna put about 1/4 cup of olive oil. It looks like it's too much, but it will just disappear, you know. You have to mix it really well afterwards, so you don't see olive oil anywhere. And now I'm gonna stir it well. And that's gonna be it. We're gonna be done. You have to stir it really well until it looks white. You know, it's not like green. You don't see all the green stuff in it. It's gonna be mostly white. Alrighty, almost done. Now you can serve that as a side dish for various meats, or you can use it with vegetable entrees. The most popular is, to serve it as a dip with pita chips or crackers. One way I like to do it is I put it in a margarita glass because it has this white opening and it looks good. And you put the margarita glass in a bowl and you fill the bottom of the bowl with crackers or pita chips or whatever it is that you're dipping in there, and you have the dip on top. It makes life a lot easier and prettier. Well, this was it.
So there you have it. Next time I will show you how to make souvlaki. Souvlaki is what you put this on. You gotta have it. So until next time, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.